Hello students, now I am going to start new chapter called General Principles and Isolation of Elements. This is also called as an metallurgy. This chapter carries 4 marks in your board examination. Now let us consider in lower classes we are studied about the periodic table. Periodic table generally consists of 118 and more elements. Among these 118 and more elements, majority of the elements are the metals. Majority of the elements are the metals. These metals, they mainly present in the earth crust. Where the metals occurs means they are mainly present in the earth crust. In the earth crust, the metals, they occurs either in the free state, also called native state, means this is called uncombined form. Some elements they present in the combined state. Generally less reactive elements they present in the uncombined form or free state or native state. For example, gold, silver and platinum, they are less reactive in nature, they present in the free state. This gold, silver and platinum called as an noble metals. All noble metals, they are present in the free state. In addition to noble metals like carbon, sulfur and noble gases, they also present in the free state. Reactive metals, they always present in the combined state, in the form of its compounds. This is the occurrence of the metals. Next, we can consider some important terms used in the metallurgy. First term used is a mineral. Mineral means it is a naturally occurring chemical substance. Naturally occurring chemical substance present in the earth crust, obtained by mining. That naturally occurring chemical substance present in the earth crust, obtained by the mining process, which contains the metal, either in the free state or in the combined state. This chemical substance is called as a mineral. Mineral means naturally occurring chemical substance present in the earth crust, obtained by mining process, contains the metal either in the free state or in the combined state, is called as a mineral. Next term is an ore. Ore means it is a chemical substance. Ore is a chemical substance. It is a mineral. Ore, it is considered as a mineral from which metal can be economically extracted. Or means the, it is a mineral. By using that mineral, you can extract the metal. Economically means profitably. If you extract the metal by mining process, we get the profit. Such a mineral we can call it as an ore. That is, ore definition is, ore is a mineral from which metal can be economically extracted. For example, you consider this minerals of aluminium are clay and bauxite. For the aluminium, the minerals are the clay and the bauxite. These two are the minerals. Among these two minerals, only bauxite is used for the extraction of aluminium. Out of clay and bauxite, only bauxite is used in the extraction of the aluminium. But both clay and bauxite, they are the minerals of the aluminium. We are using bauxite for the extraction of the aluminium. Hence, bauxite is called as an ore. But clay is not considered as an ore, because by using clay, if you extract the aluminium, we not get the profit. Hence, clay is just considered as a mineral. By using this concept, you can consider that all minerals have ores. This one is wrong. All ores have mineral. But all minerals, they are not ores. You understand this point? All ores have the mineral. To become an ore, it should be a mineral. But all minerals are not ores. This is about the ore. Next, you can consider the gang or matrix. Next term used is an gang. This gang also called as a matrix. Gang means, we know these ores are present in the earth crust. Ores are present in the earth crust. Hence, that ores contains the impurities. Those impurities we can call as a gang or matrix. That is, gang means earthy and rocky impurities. Associated with the ores. Those earthy and rocky impurities we can call as a gang or matrix, also called infusible matter. This is about the gang. Next term is an flux. Flux means it is a chemical substance used to remove the gang particles. That chemical substance is called as an flux. This is about the flux. Flux means chemical substance used to remove the gang particles. Then you consider one more is slag. Slag means a fusible mass formed by the reaction between gang and flux. Is called as an slag. Generally, this slag is lighter. It is lighter in nature. It is insoluble. in the molten metal. It is insoluble in the molten metal. This is the character of the slag. Next, you can consider the types of the fluxes. Types of the fluxes. There are two important types of the fluxes. Two types of the fluxes. Two types of the fluxes. One is an basic flux. Second one is acidic flux. Basic flux is used if the ore contains acidic gangue. If ore contains an acidic gangue, you have to consider the basic flux. If ore contains basic gangue, basic impurity, then acidic flux is used. Example for this basic flux is limestone. Limestone. Limestone composition is CaCO3. CaCO3, calcium carbonate. This is called limestone. This limestone is used in the metallurgy of iron. For the extraction of iron, we are using the limestone. That important ore of the iron is hematite. Hematite. That hematite mainly contains the silica impurity. Silica is acidic in nature. To remove this silica, we are using the limestone. Limestone decomposes to give CaO and CO2. This CaO, lime, CaO combines with silica forms CaSiO3 as the slag. This is the metallurgy of the iron. In the metallurgy of the iron, hematite ore contains silica impurity. Silica is an acidic gangue particle. To remove the acidic gangue, basic flux called limestone is used. Limestone decomposes to give the CaO and CO2. CaO combines with SiO2, forms CaSiO3 as the slag. Similarly, example for this acidic flux is SiO2, silica. SiO2 means silica. Silica. Where this silica is used means that is in the metallurgy of the copper. By using copper pyrites, we are using the silica impurity to remove the ferrous oxide impurity. Ferrous oxide is basic in nature. To remove this ferrous oxide, we are using silica impurity. That silica combines with ferrous oxide forms FeSiO3, ferrous silicate slag. This is about the types of the fluxes. Then we have to consider some important ores. For example, in our syllabus, there are four important metals. One is an iron. You have to consider the ores of the iron. For example, ores of iron are hematite. That hematite formula is Fe2O3. It is the hematite. Second one is magnetite, Fe3O4. Hematite and magnetite, these are called as an oxide ores. Oxide ores. Next one is an siderite. Siderite composition is FeCO3. It is a siderite. Siderite. The siderite is called as an carbonate ore. CO3 2-. It is carbonate ore. Next one is an iron pyrite. FeS2. FeS2. This iron pyrite is called as an sulfide ore. Next, one more is an limonite. That limonite formula is Fe2O3 3H2O. This is called as an hydrated ore. These are the ores of the iron. Hematite is Fe2O3, magnetite Fe3O4. This one is an siderite. It is an carbonate ore, FeCO3. This is iron pyrite. Iron pyrite formula is FeS2. It is a sulfide ore. Then limonite. Limonite composition is Fe2O3, 3H2O. It is an hydrated ore. Next metal is an copper. The ores of copper are chalcopyrite. Chalcopyrite or copper pyrite. Copper pyrite formula is CuFeS2. CuFeS2. It is considered as an sulfide ore. Sulfide ore. Next one is a malachite. Malachite. Malachite composition is CuCO3, CuOH twice. This is called as a basic copper carbonate. Basic. This one is a basic in nature. Hence it is called basic copper carbonate. It is also a carbonate ore. Next one is an azurite. Azurite. Azurite composition is 2 moles of CuCO3, CuOH twice. Next one is an cuprite. Cuprite composition is Cu2O. Next one is an copper glands. Copper glands. Copper glands formula is Cu2S. This cuprite is an oxide ore while copper glands is a sulfide ore. These are the ores of the copper. Similarly, one more metal is zinc. Zinc important ores are the calamine. Calamine composition is ZnCO3. It is a carbonate ore. Zinc blend A. Zinc blend A. Zinc blend A composition is ZnF. It is a sulfide ore. Then one more is zinc site, ZnO, oxide ore. One is an calamine, ZnCO3, carbonate ore, zinc blend A, ZnF, sulfide ore, zinc site, this is ZnO, it is an oxide ore. These are the ores of the zinc. Last one is an aluminium. Aluminium main important ore is an bauxite. Composition is Al2O3, 2H2O. This is about the occurrence of the metals. In the next video, you can see some general principles used in the metallurgy. Thank you.